tuning in to the online broadcast network, AfterBuzz TV. Over 20 million weekly downloads from over 200 countries and your number one source in after-show entertainment. AfterBuzz TV, the destination for TV superfans, producing aftershows for over 300 of your favorite TV shows, interviewing celebrities and showrunners, and bringing you behind-the-scenes exclusives. All completely free, thanks to E! Entertainment's Maria Menounos, producer Kevin Undergaro, and internet leader Akamai. Now, let the buzz begin!
Hey everybody, my name is Keetin Marchi. I'm here hosting another Spotlight On with the amazingly talented, beautiful, hysterical Meghan Heffern, who actually picked out this song.
I did. We are twin. Obsessed with them.
You guys, look these guys up. They have what, five songs out?
They have five songs, and they also do a cover of Drake's Just Hold On, and they're playing at the zoo this Saturday? Friday. At the
Friday.
Zoo.
Check it out, you guys. Yeah. Meghan will be there.
I'll be there, front row.
So Meghan, you're a Canadian actress. You've been doing this for a while, which is amazing. You've literally spanned every single genre. You've done film, you've done web, you've done television, you've done everything, but you didn't get started actually until you were around like 15 years old, is that correct?
It's true, yeah. I started when I was about 15. I really wanted to meet Hanson. I don't know if you knew that.
So before the show, we were talking about which song will open us up, and we you know, threw on Umbop.
It was Umbop or We Are Twin. I went with We Are Twin, yeah. I moved to a small town, and I really wanted to meet Hanson. It was so 14, and my mom was like, let's get you an agent. We lived in a small town, and so I did, and she ended up actually taking acting classes with me, and she ended up booking stuff.
That's my mom, so much fun.
I know, I was so jealous. And then I just, like, fell in love with it, and fast forward, actually 2 years ago, I met Hanson.
Was it everything you dreamed of and more?
It was everything I dreamed of and more. It was great.
Did you tell him you are the ones to blame or to thank for what I've gone through?
And you know, I did tell them that, and they were so lovely, and they talked to me for like half an hour, which like blew 14-year-old Meghan's mind.
That's amazing.
And I didn't cry.
Good.
So
that's good.
I won.
That's really awesome. You did. You won. So your mom was booking roles, but your first thing was as a stand-in, correct?
Yeah, I started as a stand-in. Actually, no, I started as an extra on a family show, and then they sort of liked me and their stand-in quit, so they
bumped
gave
you up
me
to
a
stand-in.
Promotion. Yeah. It was a great job. I was 16, I think. So.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
So it was just Hanson. There was nothing, like, as you were growing up that really influenced you or made you want to be an actress?
I don't want to be cliche and say I was always performing. I feel like a lot of people always say that. I mean, I dance competitively.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know if I'd like acting. I just knew that I wanted to meet Hanson. It was, like, the main goal. And then I obviously fell in love with it, and that became, like, a hilarious story that I could tell people, like,
that's a great story.
It is a great story.
I love
that.
So, I mean, the first time you were on set, was there something, like, when did you know, okay, I made the right decision, or, like, this is what I'm meant to do for the rest of my life?
Yeah, I think actually the first day I was on set, being an extra, I was just so impressed by how everybody worked together to make this one project.
Mm-hmm.
And it seemed just, like, insane to me how everyone had their specific job and then came together and did it. And then I just kept on wanting to be an extra, which was strange. And it was, like, the best thing ever to do in the summer when I was 15. And then being a stand-in, I kind of took, like, each week, each episode, and focused on different things in different areas of the set. Mm-hmm. So one day I would learn about editing, and the other day I learned about lighting, and on and on and on. And it was kind of like a no-brainer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So if you weren't an actress, would you still be working in film and television production, do you
Absolutely,
think?
Yeah. I don't know what I'd be doing. I don't know what I'd be good at. But, yeah, definitely. I love crew. I love being on set. It's really special.
That's I love this industry because the set camaraderie is just the best.
Yeah. There's nothing like it. It's awesome.
Absolutely not. So since then, you've been in over 30 film and TV.
Oh, my gosh.
You have over 30 film and TV credits. So what has kind of been your favorite thing to do? Like, is there anything that's really stood out to you?
My favorite project that I've ever been a part of where the end product was, like, blew my mind was definitely What If, or the F word in Canada. But I've had so much fun on so many different things. Like, I love doing Backpackers because we got to go to Paris. And I love doing American Pie because all the guys on that show were amazing. And Blue Mountain State is, like, a whole other amazing thing, too. And every movie is kind of, I've sort of taken one friend from each movie. So it's great. It's, like, every project is good.
Absolutely. So what was the first role that you were like, oh, my gosh, I think I've made it?
Definitely American Pie. That was my first. That was my first thing. It was so much fun. It was the first time I'd ever left home, and I was living in Vancouver at the time, and they flew me out to Toronto. It was like this whole summer camp, American Pie style. So,
what was it like being on a set of an American Pie movie?
Crazy.
Yeah.
Everything that you can imagine.
Do you have any funny stories or things that you are like you can share?
I don't know if I can share any of them. To be honest.
She pleads the fifth, ladies and gentlemen. So do you prefer TV or movies? You've done so much of both.
I love doing TV. It's a longer process, so you kind of form this, like, family bond with everyone. But there's something really cool about doing a movie about, you know, spending the month or 2 months doing it, and then it's out, and, you know, there's film festivals, and it's all very fancy and great. It's different. Yeah, it's different.
Do you enjoy the whole kind of press part of a movie, like the red carpet, the press junket, and all that stuff? Do you like that?
I mean, I'm incredibly awkward on the red carpet. I feel very, like, weird and uncomfortable. I think it's really fun to dress up. I think it's really fun to go out and promote something that you really believe in. But I always get so, like, I feel so weird and awkward on the red carpet. People yelling your name. I don't know. It's strange.
Yeah, you don't like it?
Do you ever I want to learn to like it.
Do you think at a point when you start liking that, then, like, it's like you might cross a line? Or
I feel like that's true, yeah. I don't know how anyone could not be awkward.
Yeah, yeah.
Because if you actually watch someone posing on a red carpet, it's hilarious.
Can you give me
I mean, it's a lot of, like, like, oh.
What angle can you see I'm just me like, at now?
I can't do it, but I applaud those girls who take really good red carpet photos, because it's tough.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And, I mean, you're so stunning, and so I'm sure you're gorgeous on the red carpet, but, you know, you're such a pretty girl, and you are so funny. Like, I watched your reel, and, like, you're hysterical, and I feel there's this weird thing where it's like, if you're pretty, you can't be funny, or what do you feel about that, or being a girl who is so into comedy and is as good as you are?
I know so many beautiful girls who are hilarious, so I think it's kind of, I understand it's sort of a thing right now that pretty girls, oh my god, that pretty girl's funny. I think it's because there's so many sort of boxes that we put beautiful women in, like, oh, you're going to be the bombshell, or you're going to be this, and then the funny ones are the quirky girls. So
yeah.
I think that just because you're beautiful, you can still be quirky and funny.
Aww.
I think it makes sense.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
It's funny because you've, like, I've seen you as kind of the quirky girl, but I've also seen you as, like, the hot cheerleader, too. So you're able, like, you're like a chameleon. You're so able to kind of do whatever.
Thank you. Something like that was, like, coming right
Okay,
off.
You guys. So do you prefer comedy or drama?
I love them both.
Okay.
I love doing comedy. It's so hard. Doing sitcom and it's so, so hard. It's such a challenge for me. And drama is, like, exhausting sometimes.
Yeah.
But they both have their challenges. I love them both. I just don't ever want to pick.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if I ever could.
Really?
Yeah.
That's awesome. I love when actors can come in. They're just like, you know, give it to me. And, like, I like that you're like, I like a challenge.
Yeah.
Like, that's awesome. Because comedy is hard. Comedy is
so,
not easy.
It's, I came out here and got, like, I got schooled. I got schooled in how hard comedy was.
Did you study with anybody for comedy or?
Yeah, I did. I did classes with Leslie Kahn.
Me too.
Did you?
Yes, I love Leslie.
I had a feeling that you would be a part of the Constitute. I almost asked you before the interview. Yeah, no, I did classes there for almost a year, and I love it. I love them all there.
She's great. Shout out to Leslie Kahn.
Shout out to Leslie Kahn.
So you've also worked with some pretty big names in the comedy world. Eugene Levy.
Mm-hmm.
You've worked with Martin Short. What did you take away from comedy, like, from them?
I think I learned the most from Colin Mochrie.
Oh, really? Okay.
Whose Line Is It Anyway?
So
shout out to Whose Line Is It
Anyway. Shout out to Whose Line Is It Anyway!
Yeah, I did a sitcom with him, mm-hmm. and we had to do improv, and I was so terrified, mm-hmm. but he's so lovely, and I just, like, watched him, and I also have a good friend, Lauren Ash, who was on the same sitcom, who was in Super Fun Night, and mm-hmm. she taught me just, like, a mountain of stuff.
Did you ever do, like, the Groundlings or the UCB out here?
Yeah, I did a little bit of UCB. Mm-hmm. Improv terrifies me, so yes. I'm still working up the courage to continue on.
It seems like you're classically trained in that, though. Just, like, your timing of your comedy, it just seems so improvisational.
Fake it till you make it.
If you take anything away from this.
Fake it till you make it.
So, you've also been in a lot of horror movies. You were in Chloe, which is a super thriller, kind of scary, too. I don't know.
Yeah.
Thriller
is
scary.
It is. It's a little scary. Chloe.
Yeah, Chloe is very, very, yeah. very scary.
Psycho well, girl.
Crazy girl. Yeah. Crazy eyes. But it was with Liam Neeson,
yes.
who is an action star, thriller, everything just great. What was it like working with him? And
Liam Neeson is amazing. My character on that is actually a little in love with him, and... so there's a part where I had to take a selfie with him, mm-hmm. but it obviously wasn't going to be me taking the selfie, so we had to stand, like, in an embrace for a good hour and a half, and the whole time I was like, oh my god, it's Liam Neeson. Oh, we're embracing.
Pinch me.
Yeah, no, it was very strange.
And did you do much work with Julianne Moore?
No, my stuff was mostly with Liam, but Julianne was at the read-through. They're amazing. Mm-hmm. Even just at the read-through, I almost missed my lines because I was so busy watching them.
It's Liam Neeson and Julianne Moore.
Yeah. And also, Amanda Seyfried yeah. is, like, an alien. She's so beautiful. I was like, how does one look that I don't understand?
I've seen her in New York so many times. She lives in the same neighborhood as my dad. And it's like, I can just, you just know it's her because she always
yeah.
has her dog with her. And so she's like, there's Amanda and Finn.
Yeah.
So.
She's got amazing hair.
Yes.
That girl.
Stunning hair.
Shout out to Amanda.
Shout out to Amanda and her hair and her dog. We're doing a lot of shout outs
yeah.
today. So with Liam, like, he's a very intimidating guy on screen. What did, when you were embracing him, were you a little scared? Or
no,
like,
he was amazing. I mean, even at the read-through, he was like, he came and shook everybody's hand, and he was very lovely, and made jokes about Taken, and I think it's the same with Daniel, like, mm-hmm. Daniel Radcliffe, just really lovely and can kind of make fun of themselves,
because yeah.
they're in such iconic things.
Yeah.
I mean, Harry Potter, Taken.
Yeah. So, are you a fan of Harry Potter?
Yes.
Yes? Yeah. Did you geek out a little bit when you found out you were going to be in the movie with Daniel?
I did. Yeah. Yeah, and we're both really early for things, as you could tell by today, the interview, and Mr. Belding and I. Yeah, we were both at the read-through super early, and he sat down beside me, and he looks at me, he's like, I have a being early problem. I was like, I do too.
It's a good problem to have.
Damn,
when Daniel Radcliffe has it too.
Daniel
yeah, this is good to know. I'm going to start having a being early problem when
yeah,
Daniel,
when, should,
if I ever get to work with Daniel.
Anytime, yeah.
That's awesome. So to get back to kind of dramatic roles and stuff, what is your favorite thing about doing drama?
I think drama could be something like Chloe, like a thriller, mm-hmm. or it could be a horror movie, or it could be, you know, like a romantic, like The Notebook.
Mm-hmm.
So there's so many different levels of what you can kind of do being dramatic.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's so challenging.
Mm-hmm.
I did a horror movie once where all I did was cry for a month straight, and that's hard.
That's very hard.
But it's fun.
Which movie was that?
It's called Home Sweet Home.
And you cried. Have you gotten any sweet death scenes?
I've died so many times.
What was your favorite death scene?
I feel like I don't give away the movies.
No spoiler alerts here at AfterBuzz.
But many deaths.
So which movie should we watch to see your favorite death scene?
I think... Home Sweet Home. That's a good one.
Home Sweet Home?
I'm not saying I die in it, but it's pretty great.
Something happens to
Something
her in
happens
it that's very,
to me.
Very interesting.
Yes.
So... So another genre that you've been amazing in, and that's kind of done something that's you were the first, actually, to do this.
And
with Backpackers.
Oh, yes.
Which was the first time an online series produced by a broadcast network's digital studio made the transition to TV. It was on the CW seed and then was
picked
up. And
then it went to CW,
by
yeah.
CW.
It was crazy. It was very unexpected and strange. And I read it on Deadline and was like, wait, is this my show? Does this mean that do I get to go back and do it? And yeah, I did. It was great.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
And that was a show, I mean, the kind of, do you want to tell us about the premise of that show a little bit?
Yeah, so it's about this couple who are about to get married and they've been together for the majority of their teenage adult lives. Mm-hmm. And she kind of decides that, you know, she doesn't want to get married. She as in myself, decides that she doesn't want to get married because, right away until they kind of experience life. Mm-hmm. So they go on separate backpacking trips. And then, of course, he regrets it and kind of spends the whole series trying to find her and mm-hmm. Chaos ensues.
So did you get to actually travel with
yeah.
the show?
Yeah, I got to go to Paris.
What was Paris like?
It was amazing. And I had the best schedule. It was really a dream job. I felt bad for the boys because they worked every day, and then myself and then Nils, who plays the Australian in it, we just kind of like hung out at this inn and walked around, and it was great. It was good.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So you really enjoyed doing that, and then did you go right from that to filming What If?
I did What If actually before I did Backpackers.
Really?
Yeah, we did What If 2 years ago.
Wow.
It was a very long experience.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so we shot it in the summer, oh my gosh, 2012?
Really?
And then it went to TIFF 2013, and then it just came out 2014.
And I have to give a huge shout out to What If, because it is literally my new favorite romantic comedy.
It's so good.
It is so good, and I think it's one of the best representations for like people in their mid and late 20s navigating love and
it's
kind
hard.
Of in the digital age and stuff, it's very hard. It's and I just felt like it was so real.
Yeah.
And I really, really appreciated that from that movie. I cried, I laughed.
I cried at the end. Every time
oh
at
my
the end I cried.
Gosh.
I know. Alain Mastai is a brilliant writer. He did such a great job. It almost seems like so many parts of the movie seem improvised,
mm-hmm.
but they weren't. He's just such a great writer.
Really?
Yeah.
They weren't?
No. I mean, I can't speak for all the
yes,
parts,
yeah.
but for some of them, yeah, no, there weren't. It's just such brilliant writing, and Zoe is amazing, and Dan is amazing, and they
mm-hmm.
have such great chemistry together, and Michael did such a great job directing everybody. Yeah, it was such a dream job.
It was almost like The Office when I watched it. Like it did feel just so like,
yeah.
these guys are just all really good friends.
It
and
just
they're
seemed...
They're just playing out their lives
yeah,
right now.
Yeah, it just seemed easy.
Yeah.
They were just so easy together, and they had this really beautiful, lovely friendship in the movie.
Yeah.
And off screen, too.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
And you guys kind of were all good friends, because that did span that long of time that you guys did were
yeah.
able to...
I mean, I lived in Toronto, so I mostly knew all of the Canadian cast that
mm-hmm.
were in it, because it takes place in Toronto, shot in Toronto, lots of Canadian talent in it. And then they all, I think a lot of them live in New York and L.A., but
mm-hmm.
yeah.
That's awesome, because the other thing that I loved about it was that it was shot in Toronto, and it featured Toronto. And I've never been to Canada. I've been all over the world, but I've never been to Canada,
you
and I want to go so bad, because Canadians are the nicest people in the world.
if
you don't know a Canadian, meet one immediately.
you know one now.
Yeah, but it made Toronto. It was almost like 500 Days of Summer, which takes place in LA, but
yeah.
that for Toronto.
Yeah,
and it made me want to move there.
It's so beautiful. And it was cool because they were everywhere. Like, they were in the West End, and they were in the beaches, and they were in, you know, like, just all over the city. They didn't stick to one spot.
Mm-hmm. And you're not based in LA, right? You're based in Canada?
I sort of go back and forth.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you bounce back and forth.
Yeah.
But you like being at home probably the most.
Yeah, I love being in Canada.
Yeah.
But I love LA, and I yeah, it's hard to pick which one. So I just pick both.
That's, you know?
Yeah.
That nobody needs to put you in a box,
no.
right? We've already discussed this. Don't put you in a box. So, what projects do you have coming up? You've done so much. I can't even imagine what's kind of coming up for you.
So, what do I have coming up? I just did an episode of Rookie Blue.
Fun. Were you a cop?
No,
are you allowed
I was
to say
not
what
a
you
cop.
Were?
I'm not allowed to say what I did, but it's going to be great. and I'm currently doing a movie called A Sunday Kind of Love.
Another rom-com?
Yeah, it's a little rom-com. And then Blue Mountain State, the movie, starts in October.
Oh, my gosh.
Which is going to be great.
So you're about to get real busy.
Real busy.
Are you excited, though? Do you like to work? And
yeah, I'm so excited. And we get to shoot Blue Mountain State in Montreal, which is always awesome.
Fun. And it's not going to be too cold yet, right? When does it get cold in Canada?
So.
I don't know.
Maybe like December.
December?
November. Apparently it's starting to get cold in Toronto now, which is alarming.
It's August.
I know.
Don't get cold yet. Last winter was bad enough. We don't need another
one. My gosh, last winter was the worst, but I wouldn't know because I was in LA.
All you suckers in Toronto.
Sorry.
So, you know, you have all these projects coming up, but what is like a dream role for you? Like what, if you could choose to do anything, what would it be? Would it be in television, film? What type of role?
I think I'd really love to be a cop in something, like something really badass, because I have a really high voice and a pretty sweet, like, demeanor that it would be nice to, like, kick some ass. I'd love to do a romantic comedy, too. Something nice like What If.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like a little fall in love movie.
Yeah. And do you like the indie films, or do you like the bigger...
I love doing indie films.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Support the independent film market,
Support
you guys.
Support independent film.
Because it's awesome.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I know I read a little bit, and you can expand on this. Do you produce? Do you?
No. I'd like to get into that.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's such a learning curve.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's very difficult, but something that you kind of just have to do. Yeah. It's definitely something that I would like to get into.
Do you write? Do you like?
Yeah, I write a bit. My mom and I are actually writing a kid's book.
That's awesome.
Yeah, based on the adoption of my dog. Who's from Nicaragua?
What part of Nicaragua?
Higante. Have you been to Nicaragua?
I have not, but my boyfriend is currently in San Juan del Sur.
It's about 25 minutes from San Juan del Sur. Higante, yeah. You should tell him to go. It's amazing.
I used to work on Survivor, so they film at San Juan del Sur.
What?
Yes.
Weird.
I know. This is very weird things. So tell me the story about your dog, though. Now I'm curious, because I adopted my dog.
Yeah, she's from Nicaragua. I was traveling there, and... found myself in this tiny little town of Higante, and then she just lived on the beach at a taco stand. I know, it's very strange. And I fell in love with her and took her home. It's pretty much the story.
Was that a hard process to get her?
Yeah, I was really lucky. I met a girl, Chanel Kelly, who I love because she sent me my dog. Her family owned a bed and breakfast there, mm-hmm. and so she helped me out so much. She took Lola in, and she took her to Managua and got her shots and a kennel and put her on a plane to me. Yeah. So she kind of did all the heavy legwork.
And how long ago was that?
2 years. I know.
That's so awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody really should adopt dogs. If you're going to get a dog, adopt one.
Rescue.
You don't have to go all... Yeah, rescue, adopt.
You don't have to go all the way to Nicaragua. That's a little extreme. Yeah, definitely rescue.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
That's so awesome. So is there any other like things that are really close to your heart when it comes to, you know, whether it's animal rescue or any charities?
I think I'm definitely big on the animal rescue.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. That's like, I mean, obviously other things too. You put me on the spot. I'm like, oh my God, what other
she
charities?
She cares about everything.
I care about everything. Donate money to ALS.
ALS.
Yes.
You want to tell the story because it was kind of funny right when we walked in.
Oh yeah. I came here and then Mr. Belding, I don't know what his real name is.
Mr. Belding
Dennis from Saved by the Bell.
Dennis Haskins
asked me to videotape himself getting ice water dumped on his face. Dumped on his head. If you see that video.
Right here. Cinematography.
Yeah, that's me.
Cinematography by Meghan Heffern.
All me.
Well, Meghan, I'm so excited to meet you. Like, literally, I feel like you're just so welcoming and you're so nice.
Thank you.
I feel like I've known you for, like, forever.
We can be friends.
Let's be friends. We'll call Johnny Kelts and say, hey, come
on. Oh, yeah, Johnny Kelts.
Where can we find you? Like, where can we follow kind of your adventures and your
career?
Oh,
I'm on Twitter at Meghan Heffern. Amazing. And then my Instagram is at MegzyHeff.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
I really, really appreciate it. You've been such a fun interview.
Thanks.
You're awesome.
I tried.
And you guys can find me on Twitter and Instagram at Keetin Marchi. That's KeetinMarchi. Thank you so much for watching. And thank you, Meghan.
Yay.
This is Aaron.
From executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network. To watch or listen to other After shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later!
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.
Thank you for watching AfterBuzz TV on YouTube. For more of your favorite after shows and interviews, subscribe to our channel here and be sure to share your opinion on the episode in the comment section below here. We'd love to see what you guys are buzzing about. Thanks again. Buzz you later.